Facebook, for example, I mean, this has created a way of monitoring the social connections between individuals. So what that means is if we see a virus in one particular location and we know exactly how individuals are connected, we might be able to get a much better sense of how it's going to spread, because ultimately these things spread through social networks. And here's another way to think of it, right? At some point in the future, individuals just looking at their cell phone might be able to get a very sort of message about their particular risk that's catered to them individually, based on where they're likely to travel, what actually is going on in terms of their world, how many people they're connected to. I mean, this is ultimately these digital tools are going to provide us with a new, completely novel forms of surveillance. I mean, you can kind of think of this a little bit like compounding interest. Every minute, day, week, or month early that you catch these things provides you huge benefits in the long haul. So, I mean, take HIV, for example. This is a virus that crossed over from chimpanzees into humans in the late 19th or early 20th century. It took us 60 or 70 years to actually be able to catch this thing. Now, had we caught it 5 years ahead of time, 10 years ahead of time, we didn't need to catch it 50 years ahead of time, we would have totally changed the way that this virus, its ultimate destiny. We might be in a situation where instead of having 40 million infected individuals, we had something like 4 million infected individuals. So early detection is absolutely